the Downing Street COVID Daily Briefing Centre. And this guy here is the Chief Scientific Advisor to the UK government, Sir Patrick Vallance. And you just got to listen to what this guy says here, people. He's saying that the National, the Office of National Statistics COVID rates are people who have got COVID on their death certificate, but he says that doesn't necessarily mean that they were infected because many of them have not been tested. Okay, just listen to this. It's absolutely unbelievable. So in your face, just basically telling us that they are falsifying the death certificates.
Have the hospital death rate and the total death rate. It's worth remembering again that the ONS rates are people who've got COVID on their death certificate. It doesn't necessarily mean they were infected because many of them haven't been tested. So we just need to understand the difference.
Okay, just listen to that again.
Death rate, the hospital death rate and the total death rate. It's worth remembering again that the ONS rates are people who've got COVID on their death certificate. It doesn't necessarily mean they were infected because many of them haven't been tested. So we just need...
Okay, so there we go. He has just told you that people are not... Many of these people have not been tested. He has told us that they are falsifying the death certificates. Just unbelievable. How much more evidence do we bloody need? And here's the Health Secretary, Matt Hancock, from the same briefing centre in Downing Street, giving out all of the lies, all of the figures on the COVID deaths and the victims, the alleged victims of the COVID. Just all lies, lies, lies. Just listen to this. Unbelievable. The fear porn, having people living in terror.
On the latest figures, there have been 1,291,000 tests for coronavirus, including 85,186 tests on Sunday yesterday. 190,584 people have now tested positive for coronavirus, an increase of 3,985. 13,258 people are in hospital with coronavirus, and 28,734 people have died. That's across all settings, an increase of 288. That figure is lower than at any point since the end of March. But, as with testing, these reported figures tend to be lower over the weekend, so we do expect that number to rise. And remember, this is not just a number, but it is a constant, insistent reminder that we must go further and faster in our national effort in dealing with this virus.
No, it's a clear and consistent reminder that you are a bunch of lying criminals. So there you go, people. Straight from Downing Street, they have just told us that they are falsifying the death certificates. How much more evidence do we need?